Okay, I'm here with Emily Pidgeon from Conservation International. If you'd like to tell me a little bit about what the organisation does and your specific project within that organisation.
So Conservation International is an NGO focused on looking at how human communities and natural ecosystems need to coexist and how one is dependent upon the other. In my particular field, I am the director of the Marine Climate Change Program at CI, and we are focused at looking at addressing the impacts of climate change on coastal and marine communities and the environment globally. But also, just recently, we've started looking at the potential for coastal systems as a form of mitigation against climate change, something that's referred to as blue carbon. There's certain coastal systems, seagrasses, mangroves, and salt marshes, have a phenomenal capacity to sequester and store carbon. And we're just recently learning how to understand how much carbon's there, how to account for this carbon, and most importantly, how much of this carbon is released when we destroy these systems.
Might this have been areas that were ignored in the past as wasteland, land that couldn't be used for anything? Is that the kind of areas we're talking about?
Well, these systems have been we've known these systems are very important for other ecosystem services for some time now. We know, for instance, that over $2,000 billion worth of services are provided by the coasts to us every year. Communities around the world are dependent on mangroves for their fisheries. It's estimated that about 80% of the world's fisheries are either directly or indirectly dependent on mangroves. And people are becoming more aware of coastal systems as a form of coastal protection against sea level rise and storms, other impacts of climate change. But it is now that we're only now beginning to appreciate the importance of these systems for carbon sequestration and how much carbon we have released into the atmosphere by destroying these systems through development, through changes in water quality and other impacts.
I mean, talking in very general terms, what is the state, what is the condition of many of these areas that we're talking about? Are they in general being abused? Are they being contaminated, destroyed?
The best estimates that I've seen suggest that 2% of these habitats are being lost every year. And that we've lost approximately between 30 and 40% of these systems globally already. And this account, if we look at the total emissions, this loss of these coastal systems accounts for about 1 billion tons of CO2 per year. It's a number that is, while very preliminary, is actually very significant in terms of other emissions.
And are there difficulties in getting the message across? I mean, there's been plenty of information about rainforests and the importance of the rainforest for many years. We're now coming up with another area, which is obviously vitally important. But is it difficult to raise awareness, given the amount of information that is circulating these days?
Raising awareness on these issues is always very difficult, but we're just starting. Conservation International, IUCN and other partners have just launched our Blue Carbon Initiative, which will be bringing together some of the world experts on this particular topic to start to fill in the gaps and start thinking about a road forward on how to move on this. And I think that as it becomes clearer how we should progress on developing management that includes coastal carbon, perhaps developing incentive approaches for maintaining carbon in coastal systems, that awareness on this will build. And that's part of our purpose of being here, is to bring this particular important carbon sequestration or storage mechanism to everybody, to build awareness, given that we're only just starting to think about this particular area.
Okay, that's great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.